back of a quilt. I'm like, oh, well, maybe it is. Maybe we should make the front now. That's interesting and weird. I'm like, okay, sure. I was like, okay.
Oh, that's my funny. Goodness.
I know. It was a ridiculous day. Well, anything else that you want to chat with, tell us about? I love field trips. I love field trip reports. You were amazing. Was it fun to be able to share it as you were going, or was it annoying?
No, it was fun because, again, I kept looking at everything like, if I'm on the website, what would I want to see? So that's what I kept remembering. And once I had wrapped my head around that, I had to have a little bit of a plan, right?
Yeah.
And it was like, okay, would I want to see this? And I went, yeah, I'd want to see this. So that's the way I looked at it. Now, and it was fine.
Did you have any time to go into the classrooms at all?
I went into a couple of the classrooms, but I wanted to be kind of quiet and respectful of them.
Yeah.
But yeah, some of the classrooms I did go into it and just take a look. I was going to try to maybe, I know I said, I kind of did my, okay, folks, that's kind of all there is, but I was looking through my notes and looking through my, pictures. So there'll probably be a couple more things I'll put out there this week.
That's so great.
I think some kernels of things that would be good to have and everyone to know about. So, awesome.
I'm psyched. I'm so excited. And I can't wait for you to be doing more of this for us. You're amazing. And it was so much fun to watch. And the videos and your interviewing. And we'll have to get you, doing more. So you're just amazing. You found your calling.
Quilt
show reporting.
Who knew?
You're rocking.
Yeah, well, I was telling my husband, I said, I really like this. This was a lot of fun. I see reporters online. I'm going, gosh, that must be a hard job. I had a ball. I just had a ball. It was just fun getting the feedback.
Yeah, the thing is that you made us feel like we were there. That was and that's the whole point, right? So
that was my goal. That was all I wanted to do was how do I make them feel like they're there? And what would I want to see if I was watching this on the Facebook page?
Yeah.
And so as long as I kept those in my mind, I was happy with it. I figured it was going to be good. So
now,
I just
went for it. A different experience when you weren't recording or taking pictures and you were just experiencing it. Was that different for you? How was that different when you weren't being mediated by some sort of, media?
It was. So one of the other things I was doing, which you probably will have more people joining, when I could sit down and just talk with folks, like if it was three of us and we were all trying to get a table for lunch or something, I just talked and I told them what I was a part of and I handed out a card. So that's why you probably get a lot more people. I said, here, I'm with this research project.
Yeah.
And then I started talking about it and they were just so fascinated about it, about what was going on. And so I got to talk to people that probably I would not have done, right?
Yeah.
One time I was, I did everything on my phone, everything, all the pictures, all the recording, everything was done from my phone. So you can imagine the battery was draining pretty quickly, right?
Yeah, right.
And so when I would even sit down and plug in my phone, I sat by one lady, her name was Faith, yesterday, and I was plugging in my phone and she was plugging in hers. We just got to talking and she started telling me about things that I have a personal interest in. I would not have done that had I not sat there and just spent some time with her.
Yeah. Right.
She talked about art quilts and how you build an art quilt guild or a friendship group with art quilts and what they had done in the past. And that's exactly what I'm looking for here in Orange County with a group really that cool. I'm trying to help build. So it was phenomenal. And again, really cool. I would not have done that before. I usually would go into things like, okay, I'm going to touch this. I'm going to touch that. I'm going to touch this. And then I'm going to go out. Nope, this time I spoke and I talked and I got to meet people. And I think some of these folks I'm going to have a long relationship with. I know I'll be in Pensacola, right?
Cool.
I don't know if you guys are coming or not.
Yeah,
or
I'm trying to resolve a conflict, but would love for you. I know Patty's probably going and I would love for you to do it as well. So I think we should do it again there, definitely.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. Maybe there. And then we have... there's a couple of quilt shows I know that are coming up here in not just Orange County, but throughout Southern California. And there's some guilds and there's some speakers. One of the ladies who I was telling you about. Her name is Jean Impey. She's partnered with Freddie Moran. Some of our people out there may know him. And I saw her at the QuiltCon, and I was telling her about it, and she said, "I would love to do a podcast."
Oh,
and I was
so like, great.
Yes.
That's so great. I know. It's exciting when people say yes, you know?
Yeah. Really, yeah. She's a great speaker, an incredible teacher. If you guys get a chance, go on her website. She does a lot of stuff, and she is a busy bee. She is all over the place. But to know that she was willing to do that was really awesome. So I was really excited. So that's what I plan on doing, trying to find interesting things and stuff like that, like you've asked me to do this, right?
Totally. So- absolutely. That's exactly it. That's the whole point. So for those out there listening to this, if you have an event that's coming up or that you want to go to as a field trip, let us know. And it's all about, my goal is to really understand the quilting industry. And so having you there was a huge thing. So one of the things we also want to do is kind of record it. I'll try to get like a Google Doc or something so we can start to sort of keep impressions so that we understand what is the difference between Road to California and the Paducah show and the smaller ones. And so we want to sort of think through and have kind of a collective view of what all of this is. Same with the guilds. I'm really interested in guilds and being able to go to the guilds and experience it and see what it is and get reports back. But we got to think about the writing side of it because we're going to do some fancy writing too as a group, so that we can think through sort of what does this industry look like and why are the shows important. And obviously, QuiltCon is focused on modern quilts and colorful, very interesting, vibrant quilts. And so how is that different than, say, some other show? So this is just spectacular. And you can imagine, like, one person can't do it all. I mean, there's just no way. There's too much out there.
Right.
So I really, when I talk about an army, I really do want us to be an army of, you know, a collaborative army. So I don't know. But this has just been super great. Any last thoughts? Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, I think, and to just expound upon that, you get so many different perspectives from all over, hopefully not even just the U.S., but all over the world, right?
Yeah,
exactly. Of the guilds or the shows. Wouldn't it be great if we had someone at the Tokyo show or the Australian show? Or dare I say it, let's go bold, right? Go big or go home, right?
Right.
These are some big shows. It would be great if folks are going and they wouldn't mind doing three or four of them at some of these big places like the Houston show. That's three or four people maybe attacking these places and going out there and really giving us perspective. That would be wonderful.
Well, that's where we started, Jeanette. We started at the Houston show. They invited us, as media to go. So I had a media pass to the, this last one. So we'll go again. What else? I just thank you so much. You are so much fun. I cannot wait to see else we go. You are heroic.
It was my pleasure. I truly enjoyed it. I that little pin I had put up there, I had showed you guys. And so yesterday before I left, I went by again. I went, you know what? I'm going to pick up this pin because, I think I was kind of awesome.
You were kind of awesome. It's true. Well, I think you are officially a reporter for Just Wanna Quilt. We're going to be creating jobs, and you are definitely our star reporter for Just Wanna Quilt.
Oh, thank you. I appreciate it. It was a pleasure. It was I enjoyed it.
And I hope you get a little rest today. I suspect you're pretty tired.
a little rest today. I'll be working, and then I'm headed off to Pensacola. So
I love it. Love it. All right, cool. Well, I hope to see you there. And thanks again. This was so much fun.
Take care.
All right. Stay on just for one sec. So this is Elizabeth Townsend-Gard. You've been listening to Just Wanna Quilt, a research podcast coming out of Tulane University Law School. We want to hear from you. Join our army, our quilting army. Go to our Facebook page. Suggest people to be interviewed. Suggest yourself to be interviewed. We are excited to hear from you. But most importantly, I hope you get a chance to quilt today.